So the Bose Smart Ultra Soundbar is a solid choice if you're looking for a large soundbar for your TV. However, TV manufacturers like Sony, Samsung, and LG, all of these manufacturers, they want to sell you a TV, and they also want to sell you a soundbar, and they promise you better performance and more features. Now, in this video, we're going to be comparing the Bose Smart Ultra Soundbar to the Sony HTA-5000, but we're also going to be using a Sony Bravia X90L TV, and we're going to be highlighting the benefits of using a TV and soundbar combo versus mixing and matching TVs and soundbars. But this video isn't just going to be exclusive to Bose's soundbar versus Sony's soundbar and Sony's TV, which they call acoustic center sync. This video is also going to apply to Samsung's TVs and Samsung soundbars combinations, which they call Q-Symphony, and LG's TVs and LG soundbars, which they call Wow Orchestra. Now, the main benefit of using a TV and soundbar combo from the same company is, number one, your TV's built-in speakers will work in conjunction with your soundbar, which usually means a stronger center channel, and this is usually where all of the dialogue happens, so it's going to be a lot easier to understand people when they're talking on the screen. But the secondary benefit is that all of your EQ settings are going to be found directly on the TV itself. So if you want to change your soundbar's sound, you can do so easily and quickly directly from the TV. Whereas, if you were to mix and match TVs, in this case the Bose Smart Ultra Soundbar, number one, your TV's built-in speakers won't be used at all. But also, if you want to change the settings of your soundbar, you're going to have to do so from your soundbar's app. Now, don't get me wrong, the app that comes with Bose's soundbar is very well laid out and it's very easy to use. But it's not as convenient as being able to adjust your soundbar settings directly from the TV itself. And here, we're talking about a soundbar that has a very decent app. There are plenty of other soundbars out there that either don't have an app, so all of these setting changes, you have to do so with their included remote, or if they do have an app, it's a very bad app. However, if you were to get a TV and soundbar from the same manufacturer, this doesn't automatically mean that your TV's built-in speakers will work in conjunction with your soundbar. With Sony, you have to make sure that both your TV and soundbar have support for acoustic center sync. With Samsung, you have to make sure that both the TV and soundbar has support for Q-Symphony. And with LG, you have to make sure that both the soundbar and the TV have support for Wow Orchestra. And plainly said, acoustic center sync, Q-Symphony, and a Wow Orchestra might not be available on your more affordable TVs and soundbars. But now we're going to jump into the sound test. Now we're going to be comparing the Bose Smart Ultra Soundbar to the Sony HTA-5000 paired to a Sony Bravia X90L TV. Now the reason why we're using Sony's TV and soundbar here is because the HTA-5000 is a fully self-contained system just like the Bose Smart Ultra Soundbar, as in these soundbars do not come included with an external subwoofer because these soundbars create their own bass. Whereas with Samsung's and LG soundbars, with their larger soundbars, all of these soundbars come included with an external subwoofer, so it wouldn't be a fair comparison. But now we're actually going to jump into the sound test. Both the Bose Smart Ultra Soundbar and the Sony HTA-5000 are running at 75% volume. However, the HTA-5000 does have acoustic center sync turned on, so the built-in speakers in the Sony Bravia X90L TV are working in conjunction with the Sony HTA-5000. But we're also going to use the built-in speakers on the Sony Bravia X90L TV all by themselves. However, these built-in speakers are going to be running at max volume just so that they have a chance of keeping up.
Spending all my time with you, driving through the states, don't know why.
So like you have just heard, obviously any soundbar is going to sound better than your TV's built-in speakers. Your TV most likely just has a pair of downward firing speakers that bounce sound off of the table. They don't get all that loud, and when the bass really gets going, it can become a distorted mess. Now the built-in speakers on the Sony X90L get decently loud, and distortion isn't a problem for them like with some more affordable TVs out there, because the Sony X90L is considered to be more of an upper end mid-range TV. But regardless, even with the Sony X90L, you're gonna want to invest in a soundbar so that you can truly enjoy your movies. Now, in this video, the main difference between the Bose Smart Ultra Soundbar and the Sony X90L and Sony HTA-5000 acoustic center sync combo is that the Sony combo just had a stronger center channel because the HTA-5000 had help from the built-in speakers found in the TV. And with this stronger center channel, it's going to be a lot easier for you to understand dialogue with, especially when you're watching a movie. But also, Sony's combo just has a louder max volume than the Bose Smart Ultra Soundbar. But nonetheless, I will admit that the Bose Smart Ultra Soundbar is still a very capable soundbar that gets very loud, and it also has an impressive amount of bass all on its own, but more importantly, it sounds very open. But with all of this in consideration, if you have a TV from a larger brand that is also trying to sell you a soundbar, like Sony with their acoustic center sync, Samsung with their Q-Symphony, and LG with their Wow Orchestra, for the most part, I recommend that you pick up a soundbar that is going to match your TV, because then this way your TV's built-in speakers will work in conjunction with your soundbar, thus giving you a stronger center channel, which is going to be very useful because it's going to make it much easier for you to understand dialogue with when you're watching a movie. Your max volume potential is going to be higher, and also all of your settings for your soundbar are going to be found directly on the TV itself, which is just a lot more convenient. However, if you have a TV from a brand that isn't trying to sell you a soundbar, or if you have a more entry-level or affordable TV from Sony, Samsung, or LG that doesn't have acoustic center sync, Q-Symphony, or Wow Orchestra, and if you're looking for a large soundbar for your medium-sized or large-sized living room, then the Bose Smart Ultra Soundbar is definitely a solid choice. But also, there are times where you might want to mix and match TVs and soundbars, specifically if you have a Samsung or LG TV. Now, with Samsung's and LG's more premium soundbars, these soundbars come included with external subwoofers. Now, for the most part, having an external subwoofer is great because these external subwoofers are going to give you a lot of bass, and you're really going to be able to feel what's happening on the screen. However, some people just don't have the room or want an external subwoofer. So this is where a large self-contained soundbar like the Bose Smart Ultra Soundbar comes in, because it produces its own bass without the need of an external subwoofer. Now definitely, the Bose Ultra isn't going to create as much wall-shaking bass as an external subwoofer, but the important thing here is that it creates enough bass to satiate most people, and you're going to be able to feel what's actually happening on the screen. So with all that being said, your more premium TV manufacturers like Sony, Samsung, and LG, they're all trying to sell you a soundbar when they sell you a TV. Now, if your soundbar has the option to work in conjunction with your TV's built-in speakers, then I recommend that you get a soundbar that matches your TV, because you're going to have a stronger center channel, you're going to have a louder max volume, and also all of your settings are going to be much more easily accessible directly from the TV itself. However, if your TV doesn't have the option to work in conjunction with your soundbar, or if you want something big but you don't want to deal with an external subwoofer, then the Bose Smart Ultra Soundbar is definitely a solid pick if you're looking for a large soundbar for your medium or large size living room. If you made it this far, I guess you enjoyed the video, so hit the like button and get subscribed. If you want to pick any of the products up, they'll be linked down below. And if you want to further support the channel, check out the merch. I made some shirts and hoodies that look and feel great. And you know I can be very particular, so I'll only slap my name on something if I'm really proud of it.